Welcome, welcome everybody to season one, episode one of Jebena Talk. I'm your host, Misakur. To my left.
Kala.
All right. We just want to start off real quick by saying Melkam Gena. Happy Ethiopian Christmas to all the brothers and sisters out there. Hope you guys are enjoying it, spending it the safe way and the right way. You know, if you guys are already with your families, cool. If you're not, stay home, man. Stay home.
Melkam Gena, man. Yazar Abochenega Furch, you know what I mean? Hopefully everybody's having a good time with their family. You know, it's one of those things where COVID took, you know, a lot from us, especially when it comes to gathering and things in that nature.
Thanks.
But, you know, the safe way, celebrate the Yaragachundona Nasavallan. And, yeah, today we're going to be talking about if we, are you going to take the vaccine or no, Ilamilonagar, Sila COVID, no, Minara. And, you can go ahead and start us off, bro.
Personally, I'm a little indifferent. You know, for me, it's more of, I want to see a little bit more information, but in the long run, I definitely feel like I'm going to take it just because, you know, I miss hanging out with my family. I miss hanging out with my dad, my mom. Whenever I see them, I have to stay in the basement isolated. So it's like, I don't even really see them.
Yeah.
So it's tough, but.
No, definitely. For me, yeah, just like you said, if I see more data to where it shows that it's safe, because there's a lot of, you know, misunderstanding out there a lot of times. You know, we get that fast Instagram little post that says, oh, you know, Bill Gates is trying to kill everybody. You know what I mean?
Like Facebook news reporters.
It's like one of those things where there's so much misinformation going on about it
that you don't know how to
usually get the negative one too, you know?
Yeah.
And I mean, since we talked about it, I did a few research here and there to where it kind of skewed my thinking to, you know, it's like very, but I'm interesting. You want to know? It's not one of those easy things where, and in Nanta, like, we're not scientists, so we can't, you know what I mean? Like,
for sure.
It's hard.
It's complicated, bro. You can't really understand the full extent. Like,
So it's super hard. It scares me a little bit, especially, I mean, like we talked about it last time, the mRNA.
mRNA, how they come up with the coding and stuff like that.
Tinnish, it's like the genetical aspect, so that means they can change your genetics or whatnot. Tinnish into no plus. The other thing that, you know, worries me a little bit is it, the fact that it's being funded by, you know, by
there's private companies companies
that are doing it. So it's super tinnish. It's like
it's a combination though. For like so, if you look at the Operation Warp Speed, it's a combination of multiple countries, multiple businesses, and then also multiple government agencies.
Mm-hmm.
So to an extent, there is definitely going to be some liability to it, but you know.
Yeah, but you know, at the same time, you don't want to fall into that.
Which you is, don't want to be on that, the commercial. Do you have meningitis, Madame? If you think so, you might be possible to join the lawsuit.
Definitely. It's super tinnish. It scares me a little bit. But at the same time, it's one of those things where, you know, if you look at polio, for instance, and Ebola and SARS and things in that nature, bro. You know,
I mean, nobody is.
They were saying the same thing about it. You know what I mean? Facts. Oh, so, you know, somebody took it and this happened and whatnot. I mean,
it's gonna be side effects. You feel me?
At the end, yeah.
For me, the side effects. Don't get me wrong. The sore arm stuff like that, I'm cool with. The only thing I can't deal with is like that Bell's palsy that some people are getting, where their face gets stuck. You know what I mean? That's deep, bro.
That's what scares me.
But I have, so one of my good friends actually that I used to work with, he's interning at CVS, and they're doing vaccinations for certain organizations, certain rehab organizations and stuff like that.
Mm-hmm.
So one of the things that they actually did was, one of the things he was telling me was like, in terms of it actually being that like dangerous and stuff like that, it's really not. The Bell's palsy apparently goes away maximum after like 6 months.
You're gonna be out here looking like
Two-Face for 6 months, so it's not
it's one of those things, but at the same time, if it's gonna help everybody out, it's, you know,
for sure.
To intimate it.
You know what I'm saying? You've been wearing a mask for 8 months, you know what I'm saying? You can do another 6 months.
No, for sure, man. Because if it's gonna be one of those things where it can help a lot of people out, you know, and you know, a lot of people are dying, and it gets back. We're not gonna go back to normal as we you know,
right away, for sure.
But
for sure,
as time is here, you know, we're gonna get there. So I'm with it as long as, you know, I see enough data. And you know, wifey being a nurse, there's a few nurses that took it at her work, and I was telling her, like, so
when are you?
So there's actually this is when I found out there's actually two phases that you got to do it.
Yeah, it's so not you get just your one. First vaccine, and then like a week or two later they give you the second dose.
Yeah, and I'm like, what? I don't know. Yeah, like, I thought it was just one shot, you good to go. It's like,
and then it's also like how they handle it. Like, they got to keep it on like -70 degrees Celsius.
Yeah. And I was like, one refrigerator costs like 22,000, like to intern la mala to keep it.
Brother, I better get that shot.
I'm like, ASAP. What? Like, bro, yeah,
I'll pay my taxes this year, brother. I need mine first.
But yeah, no, the thing is though, a lot of times, you know, people, when we think about COVID, we always see it as a negative intent. Which is, I'm not saying it's positive, but then, you know, I'm waiting for this part. But I'm also one of those, like, with any negative, there's also a positive that comes with it.
It's like a lesson type thing, yeah.
Not just the lesson aspect of it, but there's always something to learn from it. Like, to where Ahun, for me personally, like, ever since COVID happened, I was able to, like, spend more time with my kids, because I used to complain about not spending time with them.
You also
them,
became
you know
a
what
chef.
Mean?
I see your Instagrams every morning.
I've been eating. I mean, no, I've been doing my healthy food for a minute, but,
yeah,
you know, so that by itself was like, okay, you know, you got to spend so much time with
quality
your loved
time,
ones.
Bro.
Yeah, like, and then, but at the same time, the more there's people, you know, that have been losing their job things in that nature.
I mean, forget the job, bro. Yeah. There's been people losing families. I saw a dude who was like, he lost his dad, his sister, and his aunt all in the same, like, gosh, I couldn't imagine that, bro.
Bro, that part is,
like, literally half of your family got wiped out in a matter of a year just because of a stupid, it's wild.
But then, you know, at the same time, when you know, the Veshita came about, I feel like a lot of people are not hip about, like, they need to change their diet. You know what I mean? Like, it's super hard. Like, your immune system needs to be up there to fight these, you know.
You know what I'm saying? Everybody just drinks ginger tea and takes vitamin C pills and think everybody, like, I'm good. I drink orange juice. I drink ginger tea. Ain't nothing going to happen.
Yeah.
Like, all right, brother, give it 2 weeks. Catch that joy.
It's no joke, but a lot of time, I mean, if you build your immune system, I feel like you're going to be.
Oh, for sure.
Know,
it's definitely good. For sure. Eating healthy, you know what I'm saying? Like, even in the black community, they're like the biggest underlying fact. It's like the obesity. Heart conditions and stuff like that.
Yeah,
man. They said mortality within the black community is like almost 2 to 3 times higher than the average. It's like, yeah, man. It's definitely impacting the black community. So for me personally, like, when I go on Instagram, I see people turning up in VA and stuff like that. I'm like, bro, you.
Yeah, that's scary.
You are blind, bro. Like, you guys are crazy.
That's scary. Bro. To me, that's scary because I'd be, especially with the, you know, hookah spots and thing. I got nothing against hookah spots, but.
Bro, you got to think about your family, you gotta, bro. Like, I understand you might live alone, so I guess if you live alone and you don't go see your family, sure, but at the end of the day, it's
that's the way it passes on, though, you know what I mean? Like, we are talking about hookah. I mean, hookah right there, like, you breathing, you know what I mean? Like,
when you blow out, you see the smoke, that's, your particles are going with that smoke, brother.
It's like Aladdin, you know? It's just going to be Aladdin.
Who's that?
You don't know Aladdin?
Nah, brother, I've never heard of an Aladdin. I know Aladdin.
He came from the, you know.
Talking about Aladdin?
It's
the Alibaba version.
I sound like Trump.
It's the Alibaba version. The China flu.
Yeah, like.
It's the China flu, the China virus.
Nah, that's the crazy part, but he didn't do it right, though. You know what I mean? Like, I seen one video where Obama was talking about it. He said we need to pretty much get ready for this kind of mess. Like, it's
going
to be bigger, yeah.
Oh,
and
for sure.
We should invest in that. And
for sure.
You know, when it did happen, the infrastructure wasn't there. Like, they couldn't do it.
Yeah, man. Even now, like, I think California, as of December, was fully...
again, on a second lockdown?
Not even a lockdown, but their hospitals were at zero capacity. Like, they have no room for anybody. The ICUs are overbooked. So it's like they're making makeshift hospitals in the parking lots and different areas. I'm like,
I didn't even know that.
Yeah, man, it's definitely something serious, and people are just taking it a little too lightly, from my personal opinion.
Even
us, man, we're shooting a podcast with masks on.
Yeah, you know, I mean, it's one of those, man. It's, you know, at least the least thing you can do is put on a mask and you know, try to
think about your family, man. That's the main thing for me. Is just
definitely, man.
You know, the idea of even if they don't pass away, just going through that battle. You know what I'm saying?
But you know what's crazy funny, though? I think every Habesha parent thought they have it and they're done with it. because they're like, if they had the little cold, they're like, yeah, man, it's COVID. I'm done.
You had a runny nose. It's a wrap.
Excuse me. Good if I lied, huh?
Brother.
That's not even wood, brother.
You set yourself up for failure right there.
Yeah, man, it's one of those.
Yeah, we definitely have to do our part. You know what's befallen to me, though? How everybody thought Africa was going to get destroyed. Even me personally, I thought, like, oh, if it touches Africa, it's a wrap. It's a wrap. Just because of the lack of infrastructure and everything like that. But God, you know what I'm saying? God willing, they got spared for the most part.
Yeah, but they still not
in the clear.
Not in the clear, and everybody already acting like nothing is going on. Because, again,
this is 2020, brother.
It's like, man, when it happened, you know, like,
bro, people were walking around, no masks, no nothing, bro, chilling this normal life out there.
I'm telling you, man, it's like, whoa, what's going on? You know what I mean? Like, they're doing their thing, and it's like, is it really, like, worth it or whatnot? I mean, you know, but it's commercial, though, you know what I mean? At the same
for
time,
sure.
It's
commercial. For sure. And that's the thing, like, one of the things that they were saying is, like, in terms of vaccination, whatever, they're like, oh, we don't want to be the guinea pigs, which I completely understand. Especially if the numbers aren't anywhere near the rest of the world, don't make us the guinea pigs. But now when it comes to the vaccine, we're on the tail end of it. So it's like Africa's supposed to be like one of the last people to get it because of their financial ability, whatever. And to me, like when I see places like America, Canada, and Germany buying like 3-4 times their population, like what are you expecting to happen, brother? That you need double dosage, like... How does that make sense? You think that the first vaccines are going to work, so I got to take it again?
No, the thing is, like, even if it does, like, cause sarcoma, I don't know, if a person have to take two of those shots.
Yeah.
So the chances are for each of their...
Well, so no, they're already counting. So they're saying, like, when they're counting one shot, or they're counting both doses. So they're saying, like, one person, whatever. Wow, but just to be safe, each country's getting double the amount of the... And it's like Canada got like close to 5 times their population amount. I'm like, five times? Like who?
That's not fair.
Like, what are you waiting for the future in case it happens again? Like, oh, we already got it on deck. Like, bro, you can let that happen once you vaccinate everybody, then keep making it. But right now, do it to the rest of the world. But it's savage, man.
It's one of those things, man.
It's crazy. You went from helping people, now that you got a cure, it's back to business.
Oh yeah, no, I've been back to business. You know, like pharmaceuticals
Bill Gates, man, that man is.
Yeah, they're making, you know, they're doing it. But at the same time, I feel like, I don't know, I'm not trying to defend the guy, but I seen a documentary where he was like, when it comes to the polio, he's still like helping out, trying to fight it off because there's still some hot spots in Africa.
Oh, for sure. I don't doubt that at all.
So he's doing those kind of things. And then also, like, a lot of times in India and even in Africa, because they don't have a sewer system, so when they use the shintabit, you know, zao, and then they drink that same water, which causes disease. Recycles. So he was investing a lot of money onto,
like, water purifying systems
and
stuff
so
like
that they can use the bathroom, and then the bath, you know, shintabit, the kamubala, like,
they'll clean it and they can reuse it or whatever.
For farming or anything in that nature. So... when I was looking at those things and how he really trying to change the world with
his he definitely is.
Yeah, I'd be like, a lot of times when I see the negative things, I'd be like, you know, half of the people that are saying...
Is it interpretation or is it actually like him really being maniacal and evil about his ideas? Which I agree with you on that.
But then it's at the same time, like, there's mad, like, no, Jeff Bezos, I don't know, like, I didn't go through his whole, like, what he does, man.
Bro, but he just makes money, brother.
Yeah, you don't hear anything like him trying to do like
philanthropy work and stuff like, because he doesn't care, brother. They're saying the top richest people made $1.8 trillion in the span of the pandemic.
Yeah, and what are they doing with their money to help others?
Man, Jeff Bezos about to buy another building in DC, probably.
I'm just saying, like,
about another Amazon outpost.
I got nothing against like what they're doing, but at the same time, it's like, are you like? Since you are making it now, like, you up there, like, you don't have to work for the rest of your life, man. Type of thing. Yeah. What are you doing to intermodate it? And for me, when it comes down to it, even though I might not, you know, there's rumors that he's, you know, with the vaccines he's giving, he's, you know, making people not have kids, sterilizing and things in that nature. But how true are those things? You know, I'm not I don't see any
actual facts or data to show. Like when you had the Tuskegee experience, you had clear knowledge of, like, there's documentation saying, hey, we're actually finessing the people and giving them this and not the actual medicine, whatever.
Exactly. So until a hard, concrete, like, somebody does something comes out, I'll be like, because
I mean, I'm seeing positive.
Exactly. So I'm seeing positive things from him personally, because you don't hear a lot of rich folks talking about, like, we want to change the world. You know, like, the carbon. I mean, I don't like his solution. I don't know if you've seen the TED Talk.
No.
Where he had, like, the population times this equals the carbon or whatnot. So, and then
they slowly started hitting that population control. Yeah. Like, maybe you just got to kill off 100 million people and be good.
No, and then he say something like, so one of these need to be reduced.
Which one?
Yeah. And it was kind of like instant, but then, you know, you got to take everything with a grain of salt. But he's, you know, letting you know, like, these are the things with the technology we have. X, Y, and Z, this is what we need to do to change in order to sustain Earth.
It's either change the way we the type of energy we use in terms of vehicles, companies, and stuff like that, or he's gonna start having to kill off people just to contribute. You know what I'm saying?
He's not saying it,
but in a way, it's a slight hint.
That's
good. Like, one of these factors got to change, brother. Which one's gonna be? We gonna revolutionize the industry, or we gonna start, you know what I'm saying, dropping the people here and there? You know what I'm saying?
So I mean, again, I'm with it because I've seen some positive things, but a lot of time on Instagram and things like that, they always make him evil guy. Yeah, like, I seen one where they said, oh, this guy used to make viruses on a computer and sell the antivirus. Now he makes viruses and sell vaccines and things like that. So they pushing that narrative.
Bill Gates went to Wuhan, China, and popped open a dead bat and was like, Corona spread much, and just bounced back to U.S. to the safety of Seattle.
So now you've seen it, right?
No, I haven't. Because I believe it. I definitely know there's a lot of, like, psychos out there that would just throw out conspiracy theories out the window. Like, crazy. QAnon, Anon-Q, whatever that one website is, all these Trump supporters use. It's supposed to be somebody in his cabinet that's a whistleblower on the low has a website called QAnon, like WikiLeaks.
WikiLeaks used to be good.
Nah, but what I'm saying is it's the Trump version of WikiLeaks. Yeah, so it's like all these little Trump supporters are out there QAnon. Like, bro, just stop.
Definitely. No, it's soon, isn't it? Like, one thing I hate about the little conspiracy, back in 2008, one of my friends put me on, like, with the Illuminati stuff. You remember? Jesus.
The Illuminati thing is a rabbit hole, bro. Once you go into that,
I was in there.
Then you go into the Freemasons, you know what I mean? The Child of the Lost Covenant, man.
Bro.
The Rothschilds.
I was in there, I hit my mom's up, and I said, this was back in 08, I swear. I hit my mom's up. I said, they about to round us up and put us, we need to go back home. Guys. Yeah. Like, I was serious. And she was like, I don't tell you.
That's the Habesha answer, bro.
She played it off like,
but that's the Habesha mom answer.
I was like, bro.
Jesus, he don't let it happen.
Seriously, like, you have to do your own, like, research, nugget, and understand things. But, like, don't jump off because of, like,
social media, quick, news,
like,
articles.
Yeah, Tanish nugget. Because if I want to convince you, bro, I can bring in, like, different videos and put it together.
Oh, it's all perception. And, you know what I'm saying? It's how you present stuff.
Yeah, like, legit. Like, I don't know, with the Jay-Z, they had, if you play his record backwards, it says murder, murder, Jesus. So that's one thing they said. And I'm like,
man thought about that halfway through his verse to be like, murder, murder, Jesus backwards?
No, that's what I'm saying. It's just because I don't like, I'm not the one who actually did the audio and actually listened to what it was actually saying. I just took your word for it off the video and just thought, okay, yeah, they're really doing this. I'm not saying they might not do it, but at the same time, it was like, I didn't do my own research. I'm believed just
hearsay.
Everything. Yeah, everything you said, I just ate it up. Yeah, you know what I mean? But the
right
way,
at the missile.
Yeah, no, bro, the way they put it is like,
oh,
and
no.
Now I'm like, oh, like,
bro, that clip art, clip and editing is a mother lover, bro.
Even even they get you to the point, like, they play that psychology game with you to the point where the Zafanarasu is like the background intent.
You just start hearing,
like,
noise.
No. It's not even the noise. It's like when they shown you the facts or whatever they gathered, they put it together, and then the beat in the back is like,
oh yeah, they got the suspense, the yeah. suspenseful music, like you watching an action movie, but I mean, like you just like, oh my god.
Yeah, look, I swear, they called me a few times. I ain't gonna lie,
you
bro.
Called Mom Dukes talking about we about to get put in concentration camps.
Like I used to sit, like I used to work at a gas station. I used to sit there and just watch it all day.
You got free time. My man be giving the wrong change to people, getting $10 back when they only gave him a $5.
I'm telling you, man. Like it was one of those. So they doing the same thing. They've been doing that for a minute, so they've been doing it this cajon. So, yeah.
So, and that's the thing, man. Especially with this whole, like, my thing personally is the masks. Please, please, please stop using the fact that you have a pre-existing condition as a reason to why you can't wear a mask, because statistics and facts show that those are the people who are suffering the most from COVID. So why wouldn't you want to wear a mask to protect, bro?
To begin with, man, you know we don't wear our mask the right way, by the way, right?
No,
it's covered, man. I mean, I'm not talking about just anything. I'm talking about, like, once you get in your car.
Oh, chill.
Because, like, I'm trying to tell you, there's ways that you're supposed to
put it on and take it off.
Take it off, man, I'm a nigga, right? So, for us, in order to come back to school, they actually made us do this COVID intern, like, study nigga. Like, where they give you information, and then at the end, you get, like, 3-4 questions.
My man got to pass a certification.
Yeah, you got to do at least 90% magnetalab before you enter Marat. So, when it come down to it, when you put on your mask and you take it off, you need to take it off and put it actually in a Ziploc bag. So, you can actually close it, Besanasrat.
Yeah.
And then you put it to the side. And then when you go into, because when we touching things with our hand and you just go boom, you're literally like spreading
putting
everything.
It right back.
Yeah, exactly.
Good thing when I get in the car, first thing I do is sanitize and then take off my mask.
Okay.
I have a little practice.
I'm just saying, but I'm paranoid, I've seen a lot of times they just be like, all right, I do it myself too. I ain't gonna lie. I just pick it off and then when I get home, I just hang it or put it somewhere by the, you know, by the keys, and it's already contaminated.
Yeah.
And it's like, okay, oh, you know, this.
How long does that last for, though? Like, let's say I touch something that's contaminated, or like you said, you take your mask and you just throw it on the joint. Like, how long does it stay contaminated for? Do you know?
I'm not sure, but I think they were saying it can live up to 6 hours on plastic or something like that, 2 to 3 days on wood. We have to look it up, but I'm not sure. I remember when it was there was a lot of, like,
they were giving, like, different times, though. Like, it could last a day, 3 days.
You gotta sanitize every. At some point, bro, my hands were, like, crusty.
All the sanitizer
just
eating it up?
Yeah, all the sanitizer, that washing the hand, it was like, okay. And then, it's, like, more relaxed a little bit,
bro.
You know? Like,
my homegirl, when they started the COVID thing, she started a little business where they would go shopping for elderly couples, Manamin.
Mm-hmm.
So, she was like, yo, do you mind helping me drive, Manamin? You know, take me. I'm like, all right, cool. Bro, she used to get mad because I used to always hand sanitize every single time. She's like, bro, can you drive? All you're doing is hand sanitize. How many times you going to put that on? I'm like, look, every time I get in the car,
you
no question.
Definitely. No, I mean, the little things we have to do. Like, Alan, like, when you're linking up, you're good to know. You know what I mean? Like, it's one of those things where, unless you took the shot already and, you know, in the corner, that's fine. But at the same time, the little things we can do, we have to do it.
So, back to the taking the shot, which one would you rather take? The Moderna, the Pfizer, or I think they have the Cambridge one that's about to get passed right now. Johnson & Johnson's working on one.
Yeah, there's a bunch of them working on it. There's a thing like, Arbasabat or something?
I have no idea,
but
I know like there's like 4 or 5 main ones that I know of. So those
are the famous ones, but there's a lot of people, like a lot of companies that are like...
They're like, the Cambridge one is 70% effective, but their test group is a lot broader.
Okay.
Whereas Pfizer's is like 30,000 people, all perfectly fine condition. Mm. No one that's pregnant, no kids, no pre-existing conditions, which is why you're seeing all these people now all of a sudden they're coming out with, hey, if you have allergies, if you have this and that, talk to your physician or don't even do it. You wouldn't think that America, which is one of the most unhealthiest countries in the world, you wouldn't think that to factor that into the exams and to the testing. Like, come on, brother, who do you think this is?
No, for me, I don't mind whichever one have the data. And
I mean,
that shows
both,
like,
of them are 95. Moderna and Pfizer are both 95 effective.
When I say the data, I'm talking about like people taking it and
not growing an arm.
Yeah, or turning into. They were talking about people turning into alligators or lizards. some, I'm like, bro. So
isn't it Spider-Man?
Because, I mean, if they're really switching up the genetic aspect of it, it's
That's the thing. What people aren't understanding is that technology is, like we were discussing the other time, it's been around for 20-some years. I think they're using it for either HIV or some other test. But then, wasn't this the
first vaccine that came
from
it?
That they came from that.
Yeah, that's the part where it scares you a little bit.
But that's the thing, you gotta understand how much science is going back to it from different countries, different scientists, different, you know, hospitals. It's not like it's just one company focused on it or one country focused on it. You have the whole world. So clearly, if you're using the best minds, I could see why your time's gonna be a little bit faster. If you're putting in an unlimited amount of money towards it.
When you say that though, that kind of backfires because I thought it was like different companies working towards the same goal, but I thought they weren't working together.
I'm pretty sure they were probably, if I'm not mistaken, they were sharing certain facts, not in terms of like, what they're using for their vaccine, but in terms of like what causes it, what attacks it. They were sharing that kind of information, but clearly, you know, proprietary stuff, they're not going to actually give out.
Their
secret sauce.
Technically, though, they're not like working together then, because at the end, if they're not coming up with it together, you know what I mean? So. But I guess, it is what it is.
At the end of the day, it's just they all had the exact same goal. Because, like, even the U.S., they're buying a boatload from Moderna, and they're buying a boatload from Pfizer. So
yeah, so, no, that's the thing. Once a lot of people taking it and we don't see side effects, I'm going to get it.
I mean, just off the statistics, I'm kind of anti-Pfizer. Just because didn't do any of the testing wasn't done on people like, you know what I'm saying, myself, we're a little chunky. You know what I'm saying? You didn't do anybody that had, like, asthma or anything like that. Like, you just expecting us to just go with it.
Yeah.
I'm good.
The thing is, I feel like once things are, like, more vaccines, like, they're going to make it mandatory like they always do.
No question. You know what I mean? No question. So, I mean, if you want to fly, they're saying it's about to be mandatory. If you want to go to, like, events, concerts and stuff like that, they're talking about it's about to be mandatory.
So sooner or later, they're going to try to make it. You know, make everybody take it, but at the same time,
I mean, I don't think it's a bad idea, bro.
It's not, but at the same time,
been getting shots for generations.
The same time, they should give the option because that kind of like, you know, that's violating your human rights. What if my religion says I shouldn't take the vaccine, and I'm perfectly fine? You know,
I agree. So can't argue that.
It is one of those things, but you know. Thank you for tuning in. If you made it this far, we appreciate you. You know, subscribe and comment on your...
Before we go, like always, give thanks. What are you thankful for, brother?
Oh, yeah, man. I'm thankful for, you know, for the new year coming, you know, our way, blessing us. Of course, Christmas and Kwanadabas at you again. You know what I mean? Yeah, so I'm thankful for the family, you know, my friends. You know, there's a list of things I can go into, but yeah, man.
You guys do anything special for New Year's or anything like that, given the condition? Yeah, just,
you know, it was our anniversary, 10th year anniversary. It's been a decade.
Two kids in a decade. Hey, man, that's a beautiful, beautiful thing.
Appreciate you, man. Yeah, so actually, I'm thankful for that, you know.
Myself, same thing, you know, being able to enjoy another year with my family, being able to just chill with them, enjoy some, you know, quality time, gonna spend good night with them as well.
You became a grandfather.
You feel me? my dog had some puppies. That was the first time performing labor, you know what I'm saying? I felt like a doctor and they had my gloves and stuff, you know what I'm saying? Got 6 healthy puppies, boys and girls. So
yeah, we're gonna name 3. One of them Jebena.
When they're able to go outside, we're definitely gonna bring them on and do a little episode on that, because that's something I personally want to venture into is breeding. Don't believe the negative hype about it, man. Especially not about pit bulls, man. People have this horrible misconception of pit bulls. You're gonna love mine. You're gonna love mine when they come. I'm gonna bring my mom Dukes. You know what I'm saying? She's gonna come with her puppies. You know what I'm saying? We're gonna have a nice little episode on that. But you know, we appreciate you guys. Like you said, like, subscribe. You can find us on social media as well.
Also comment what you know, thankful for, you know, like we want to hear what you got to say.
Let us know what you guys want to see, what you guys want to hear us talk about. And, we'll go from there, man. So catch you guys on the next one.
Thank you for tuning in and no da chualen.
You know what I'm saying? Enjoy the Dodo Wet.
Oh yeah, that Dodo Wet. You feel me?
I don't know about the Tresega. Man, that's not for me.
You didn't even mess on. What are you talking about?
Yeah. Bro, that doesn't mean I can't enjoy eating, bro. What the?